Okay, good morning, everybody. It is 1:13 a.m. as I am recording this because I put this off for a very long time because I was pretty much dreading recording any videos out of vanity, but more because it doesn't mesh very well with how I teach. I think, and again, this is a different kind of vanity, I think that I am actually not bad at connecting to students in a classroom. And I think that by the bringing a certain amount of enthusiasm to a lecture, I can actually keep people interested in what we're doing, even if it seems like it's a bunch of tedious math. I feel like we can still kind of keep going forward in a way that might run contrary to some thoughts on how pedagogy should work. Which is to say, it's a very popular idea at this point to turn your education into a lot of hand-holding where there are worksheets that you will complete. And having done so, you should now understand the content contained within this worksheet. And it is anachronistic and maybe a little foolish to think that it's worth clinging to a traditional lecture format. And I'm not so naive as to insist that we do everything the way we would have done it in 1925, when quantum mechanics was just slightly newer than sliced bread, literally. But I do like to have that 40 minutes and 40 minutes that stretches into 45 or 50 minutes of our class time dedicated to working through a derivation with you guys on the board. And I think that's just going to be difficult to do in this format. And I sincerely hope that you didn't think that I was squandering your time during this semester by doing that. I know it doesn't always connect for everybody. But I think it's, if you're able to keep up with the material, I think that that can actually be this is a foolish sounding thing to say. I think it can be kind of a joyful experience, a really good lecture. And I'm not there yet as an instructor, but I'm working on it. A really good lecture is an absolute pleasure for the student, or at least it was for me. And again, this is another kind of vanity, right? To insist that everybody has to learn the exact same way I do. So we are going to do a lot of teaching through the internet for the remainder of the semester because we are living through very strange times indeed. I've been in contact with you as much as I thought I reasonably could without becoming a nuisance. So thank you for getting back to me with information about your access to internet resources. And I am going to stop and save this file now, as rambling and incoherent as it may be, like I said, 1:13 when I began, and upload it to YouTube and then just start sending stuff up there talking about Fourier analysis, which is something I think that we've been underemphasizing in our curricula for too long. It's an incredibly useful tool. And I don't want you to think of something like that as, here is my math homework. I've completed it. It's not like doing conjugations in Latin, just, you know, somebody set you a homework assignment and you have to go do it. The reason to do some of this analysis is because it becomes one of the most useful tools you'll have in your pocket. And you're going to take it out time and time again to solve complicated and challenging problems. Maybe not as complicated and challenging as being a student during a time of a pandemic. I keep kind of edging back into that topic because I think it's also important to know that you're part of an academic community here on campus in our department. So you're part of a university and you already know that because EKU really leans on that pretty hard in their communications to its students. But you're also part of a smaller community because you're connected. Most, but not all of your majors, but you're connected to the physics department and physicists. This might be the vanity, the narcissism of what's the expression? Vanity of small differences, narcissism of small differences. It might be the narcissism of small differences to say it, but physicists, we think of ourselves as being something a little bit different from other kinds of academics. So you're a part of that community, and you're also part of a larger community of physicists across the world. And there are a great number of us who are all wrestling with what's happening right now. So I like I said, I keep edging back towards this topic because I want to broach it with you and say, if you're struggling in any way with what's happening, you're not alone. I certainly am. And I'm very happy to volunteer that information, not because it isn't embarrassing for me. It is a little bit, but I want that embarrassment not to stop me from talking about it. So if you're wrestling with anything and you want to talk to someone about it, I will listen to you. I am not trained in how to help you find solutions for stuff, but I can point you towards people on campus who can. We do have some services available for something like that. And I am happy just to be a sounding board to listen to you. I know that you're 20 years old and I am 39, and you are uninterested in confiding all of the most troubling thoughts you have in me because you see me as a different kind of person than that. But if you do need somebody to talk to, I would encourage you to, that's the most staid and banal sounding language. I would encourage you to reach out. What I'm trying to say is you can send me an email or call me and we can have a conversation if you need somebody to talk to. And if you want help navigating the ways that EKU and our community can help you during this time, this very, very, very strange time. All right, I'm going to click stop on this, listen to half a second of it and become horribly embarrassed. That's the other kind of vanity. And then post it and then start recording another video about Fourier analysis. Or several videos, and we'll send them up to the Blackboard website. Well, we'll put links to the YouTube stuff on it. I'm going to use YouTube as opposed to just posting a video, because if I post 2 gigabytes of video, we will burn through your data plan if you're using a mobile device to watch this. But if we use YouTube, we won't burn through that much data because it has an automatic compression algorithm that it runs. All right, guys, thank you for your patience, and I will talk to you more shortly.